All right. We're going to talk about dynamic DNS, which is a way to solve one particular problem that you might have, especially if you don't have access to a static IP address, an IP address that does not change, which is a common situation in homes. The problem is DNS records point to an IP address. That's not a problem. That's just the beginning of the problem. The problem is your home IP address can often change. Dynamic DNS is most likely something that you're going to use to address a problem getting to your home, because if your home IP address changes and you're away from your home and unable to check and figure out what that IP address is, often you might lose access to things that you might be running on your home computers. So your home IP address changes and you need to know that home IP address in order to, for example, access a server that's running inside your house or to access certain services like remote desktop or other things that might be running inside your house. The solution, There's kind of two options. You can either pay your internet service provider for a static IP address, which may or may not be an option depending on your internet service provider, or you can set up dynamic DNS. And dynamic DNS is the most commonly used way to solve this problem inside a home, because ISPs charge, you know, I've seen somewhere around 10 bucks a month for a static IP address. And I just looked and my internet service provider doesn't even offer static IP addresses anymore. So I have to use dynamic DNS. The requirements to do this, you have to have a public IP address at your router for this to do you any good at all. If you don't have a public IP address at your router, that's going to be a topic for another video. So let's talk about what this looks like. How does this dynamic DNS software work? The way that it works is, let's say you set up a DNS record. You have a DNS record, you've paid for a domain name somewhere, you have a DNS record like myhouse.is404.net that points to an IP address that is your house, the IP address that is the public IP address of your router. And once you've got that set up, you can use that IP or that domain name to access your house. And that's great. And it'll work forever as long as this address doesn't change. But as soon as that address changes, we've got a problem. So what do? We install a little program. This little program, and we'll talk about, there's a bunch of options for what program to use and how specifically it might work, but we're just going to talk about kind of from a general perspective, what's the idea? The idea is you've got a program running inside of your network that is checking to see what your IP address is. And it's sending out requests to the internet to say, hey, what's my IP address? And there's a bunch of services that might be used for that, but it's going to send out a request and say, what's my IP address? The internet, whatever service you use, responds and says, hey, it looks like your IP address is 55.29.21.5, which is the same one that we had, or that's the one that we have. That's great. That's fine. And we can send these requests, and dynamic DNS, this little program, is going to send these requests, I don't know, every minute, every 30 seconds, every 5 minutes to check and see if this IP address has changed. So when the IP address does change, this program is going to run again because it's running every minute or every 5 minutes or whatever. It's going to send out a request and say, hey, what the internet? What's my IP? The internet's going to respond and say, hey, it looks like it's 105.8.14.241. The program then says, ah, it's changed. It's changed from what it was before. So I need to update that DNS record. So, hey, DNS server, myhouse.is404.net is now at 105.8.14.241. The IP address has changed. So sends that message out to the DNS server to say, update that IP address. The IP address changes. The server responds and says, gotcha. And now we've got a DNS record, myhouse.is404.net, that points to our new IP address. And that's it. That's all dynamic DNS is. Super simple idea, super simple implementation, really. So how do you do it in practice? The way that you need to do it is you need to get a domain name, and then you need to run that program, whatever one version of that program, inside of your home network. So what I would do, if I didn't want to buy a domain name specifically for this, or if I didn't already own domain names that I could use for this, then I would use a service like DuckDNS. DuckDNS provides both the application that you run inside your network, and they give you a free subdomain of one of their many domain names that you can use, so that you have a domain name that points to your house. It's going to be, you know, something like myhouse12345.duckdns.org or something along those lines. I don't know exactly what their domain names are, but this is a free option if all you need is a domain name and you don't want to run like a public facing website on that domain name. Then you can use that for Minecraft servers, for whatever stuff you might be wanting to run inside your network. DuckDNS, great option for that. If you do own a domain name, or if you want to buy a domain name, or we're thinking about buying a domain name anyway, then These are great options. First, I would check to make sure your DNS provider offers dynamic DNS. I really like Cloudflare. Cloudflare is the one that I use the most right now. I've used Namecheap in the past. I didn't really have any complaints about them. They're great, but both are great options and offer dynamic DNS. Then I would check, does your router support it? Because again, one of the requirements is that you have an application running inside your network. If your router supports dynamic DNS, then just use that. Just figure out how to configure the router to update your DNS records and you're good to go. If your router doesn't support DNS and you've got a cloud or a DNS provider that offers dynamic DNS, then I would use this program called Inodyne. Inodyne. Just Google it, you'll find it. And I would run it on a Raspberry Pi or a Linux server, or if you're on Windows, you can use the Windows subsystem for Linux to run Linux, or a virtual machine, whatever. You need some version of Linux, I think, to run this software. And it runs inside your computer, runs on a computer inside your network, and you configure it to check your DNS, and it does all of that stuff for you. So great software, look into it. Now, one thing to be careful of, don't use Inodyne on a computer that leaves your network. Don't put it on your laptop, because when your laptop moves to a different network, it's going to recognize that the IP address has changed. It's going to update the DNS record to now wherever your laptop happens to be, which isn't going to be your home anymore. So make sure it's on a computer that is on your home network and stays on your home network and isn't moving around. You don't want it on a laptop that you take outside of your home, or else the whole point of this is gone. So this is what I do. I have a domain name registered with Cloudflare. I've created an API key to be able to edit those domain records. And then I use Home Assistant in my house. That's a computer that's running an application. There's a plugin for Home Assistant to update my Cloudflare IP address. Whenever the IP address changes, it does that checking and all of that stuff. So that's what I do on my home network. Really like it, super simple. But this other solution also works equally well. So check yourself. What is the problem that dynamic DNS is trying to solve?